Birmingham Jamaat elders formed this Jamaat with a vision, with a dream.
I think Birmingham, in one way, is looking towards its future. We have now acquired a lot of pieces of land across the footprint here. So the Birmingham project has been in the making for quite some time. We initially started with the plans for the Ghusalkhana, and part of the Ghusalkhana was to have a family room where the family could grieve in privacy. We have managed to deliver that. We also managed to deliver the mezzanine floor where we needed the extra space in the Sayyida Zainab building. What we're embarking on now is the new phase for the mosque and the Imambara. The new project will deliver on various fronts. First of all, the size of the halls and the namaz facilities are going to be just over twice the size of what we had previously. We're going to have facilities for those with special needs, disabled toilets and changing facilities. We're also going to have mini moment rooms in the ladies and the gents. And finally, the most important, the kitchen is going to be at least three times the size, with a serving kitchen on the first floor.
I'm excited to see that this project includes a library which caters to the needs of our community members. Having a library as a part of this project gives our community members something to look forward to, something exciting to look forward to.
The current project AIC is so important to this, our madrasa, our loving madrasa, is because we are lacking space for accommodating all our children. We have a lot of applications who are on the waiting list, and we really need to get these children on madrasa books. Once we have the space, we will be able to accommodate all the children of our community, enroll them all on our madrasa, and make our madrasa a real community madrasa.
I think we need this project because we need to really invest in our future generations. We need to make our mosque attractive. We need to make our facilities top notch. We need to have stuff for sports. We need to have an active social life within the mosque as well. And it needs to be fit for purpose. Our old center needed a big refresh. This huge investment, inshallah, will give us plenty of opportunity to keep giving great service for generations to come, inshallah.
Sports is really important in helping our kids, be better Muslims. Things like fair play, Islam teaches us to be fair. The facilities that we have at the moment, unfortunately, is just not enough for us.
The benefit of having our own sports center is, number one, cost. It provides a better alternative, and we can pass on those savings to our young members. The second is that it's a safe environment that kids can come in and that parents can come to, and parents can send their children to, knowing that their kids are in a safe and controlled environment. And the third is the fact that they're just around the corner from the mosque, and it builds and harnesses that spiritual aspect as well. It enables our young members to create strong bonds amongst themselves, which last a lifetime, and also builds up the foundations for a stronger community.
So what we are looking for is a constant income stream, direct debits, one-off contributions, whatever you can manage, whether it's a pound, whether it's £10 a month.
But alongside that, promoting this to your friends and family, getting the word out there, volunteering your time as well. These are all ways that you can play a part.
We all want to have a beautiful house. We want to have a beautiful shopping center. Why not dream of having a beautiful Islamic center? Let's do it. There are so many religious organizations in this beautiful city of Birmingham. Why not have an excellent center for the lovers and followers of Imam Sahib al-Asr wa al-Zaman?